around 3 years ago when we started studying with Sanjay. The book was still not ready. It was in the paperback beta testing.
Yeah, what is going on?
Yes. He told me, "You want to study?" I said, "Yes." First question, what are the sthanas of Ashtanga Hridaya? And then I did not know. And then what are the chapters of first sthana? And I did not know. And he said, "Look, this is the most basic information that you need about Ayurveda. How do you don't know that?" I said, "Sanjay, I was not taught about it." Oh, I will not say that I was not taught. I was taught just like in a very brief and not important manner. And when we are studying now, I said, I realized why Sanjay asked me 3 years ago, what are the sthanas, what are the names of the chapters and so on. But there was another thing that it was very bright for me in that moment. He was speaking about the tradition of Ashtavaidyas in Kerala.
Yeah, yeah.
And from this we go to another big issue that we are losing the Vaidyas. But before we get to that point, let's see what we are losing. So, before we go for the scenery of Ayurveda in whole India, let's make the point that Ayurveda in Kerala was very well protected from being corrupt and destroyed. This is one point. What are these families, its importance? And then we go to the current states of legal issues against using medicines of the jungle.
As I told you in the beginning, there are families, there were families and there are families who took Ayurveda as their profession. It is transferred from generation to generation, guru, shishya, bandha. Actually, the father will give all the knowledge to his son and the son again to his son. Like that, it was practiced very strongly. At that time, there was no restriction of this university certificate is required for practicing or anything. It was a respect given by the society for a Vaidya. Again, the problem with the university educations and university customs which are brought to the countries like India.
After the independence.
Probably after the independence, and recently it is very strict now, very strict now. Without university certificate, one cannot practice. So, this is one of the drawback that which we lost the Vaidyas, because they do not have the plus one, plus two or 10th class or entrance examination or entering into VMS and completing BMS such degrees. But they may have the knowledge. Kerala is taking a great strain to protect the very old people who are having very good knowledge in Ayurveda. But the new generation, it is compulsory that they are supposed to take the BMS degree to practice. Otherwise, the university will consider it as a fake Vaidya. This is very important in Kerala now. Maybe to standardize the things, maybe to avoid the fake Vaidyas, original fake Vaidyas.
The proper fake Vaidyas.
But unfortunately, very good able Vaidyas also may be badly affected by these things, because they cannot come to other sciences, physics, chemistry and etc. They are very good in Ayurveda and the sciences which is required to understand the Ayurvedic science. This is happening not only in Kerala, it is happening all over India, where their great scholars were existing, still existing, and they are not getting the students to learn it. That is another thing. There are many scholars, many great Vaidyas still surviving, but they are not getting the scholars to spend some 10 years with them to learn that Ayurveda devotedly.
In a guru-shishya bandha.
Because they are all fashioned with this university education.
And we can call this the jungle Vaidyas, at least in the Kerala.
If you ask about jungle Vaidya, there are great tribal Vaidyas available in Kerala in remote places. They are called tribal Vaidyas. They are doing marvelous job in the science of Ayurveda, but they are not considered as the doctors. the term doctors is not given to them, the Vaidya terminology is not given to them, but they are doing marvelous job. Now the young generation, interested students, they will go and stay with them and learn their techniques little and coming out. In such a way they are being protected. But there are many, many in Kerala, if you take Wayanad, if you go, there are so many people who even now know so many herbal plants which are not known to the university education. They are using lot of local herbs which can do marvelous job in even incurable diseases. They are doing the curability because of their knowledge in the connection with the nature. They are called tribal Vaidyas.
Tribal Vaidyas, okay. One point is important, that if they, if there is any kind of people against them, they can actually put them in jail because they are being fake Vaidyas, right? They are using medicines that are not registered.
They will be charged. Legally, they will be charged.
So this is one very important point, because I when I was taking classes and he told me that, I said, look, one of my fantasies that these people were still available to be living in India, just crushed in the ground. And this was very sad to me, because I had this idea that this type of people were still respected and get proper recognition, but this is not actually true. They can be put in.
See, there are old, very old generations, old Vaidyas. They are being respected. They are being respected. There is no doubt. But present young generation, when you take, government has no other measure to calculate who is fake and who is not fake. So they constituted a rule that after this year, whoever practicing should have the university degree, even though he may be from whatever be the background. That is very strict rule, very strictly implemented in.
In Kerala, it's around from 70s?
17 or 80 they are kept at the margin.
Okay.
After that, whoever taking, they should have the degree with them, otherwise they cannot practice.
Okay.
There may be few good doctors who are losing the chance to serve the people, no doubt.